Hey, 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 how are we doing, people? What's going on? Today, we're going to talk about XSplit and why you may want to consider it instead of OBS. Are you ready? Grab your cuppa, find a comfy seat. Let's do this. First and foremost, what is XSplit? XSplit has got two softwares. One, that is the Broadcaster, which is a software similar to OBS and VCam. VCam is something that you can maybe achieve with plugins on OBS, but not really, because VCam is a software of its own where you can connect your camera to and you can apply effects onto the camera. Let's install both of them. You just need to click on the download button on both and then install them. And we're going to see what they're all about, all the features. Before we go any further, one of the biggest differences between XSplit and OBS, the XSplit is a paid solution. Now, let's go have a look at the pricing. So the plans are 1 month, 12 months, and lifetime. If you want the premium bundle for a month, is about $28 Australian. So all those prices are in Australian dollars because, well, I'm Australian. So $28, I reckon it will be about 17 to 18 bucks American. And 12 months, instead of being 100 bucks, it will be probably 80. And then lifetime, instead of being $320, it will be probably $250 American. If you want to just start it out, try with a month. If you want to keep going with this software, the only plan that I recommend is the premium bundle. And that's the one that I got. Because no matter what they do with the software, like all the new features, all the betas, all the new releases, they're going to be included into the plan that you bought. And you do not have to pay anymore. No matter if, you know, in a month's time or 2 months' time, from $100 it goes to $150, you already bought it. When you first get it, it will be like this, completely blank. So first things first, let's go have a look at the settings. I will slow down a bit so it gives you a chance to stop the video and copy the settings that I have. So this is general. If you do have one screen, I will highly recommend to do enable in-game HUD. What it means is you'll be able to see your chat and your alerts on stream. So while you're playing a game, it won't be shown in the recording, but you'll be able to see it while you're playing your game. Audio. If you do not have a program like Wavelink, Voice Mirror, you do want to keep it at default microphone, default speaker, and audio preview, you pick your headphones. And then once you're done, just click apply. I won't change the audio preview, otherwise you'll be hearing the feedback. And trust me, it's not noise. Hotkeys. If you have like a Stream Deck, Touch Portal, a separate keyboard just for hotkeys, this is where you set them up. Sharing, that is where you add your YouTube, so you're authorized to upload videos on YouTube directly, and then you get advanced. Take a moment to have a look, maybe stop the video. As prompt, we're gonna add the source. You can add up a desktop capture. I do prefer it from time to time, because if I do, for example, game capture, sometimes it doesn't auto detect, but it's not a problem with XSplit. OBS does the same. But otherwise, if you, for example, like me, you have more than one monitor, you can select which monitor you want it to capture. Even if you have one monitor, you can do the same. So it will capture whatever is on the monitor. Then you can add your camera, audio device, text, web page. This is pretty straightforward. Or scene, audio file, image file. This is the same as OBS. Or you can add an RTMP stream. What it means is if you want to multi-stream, this is how you can. Also, background, lower third. Let's put it like this. Actually, let's add my camera first. And we add this. There you go. It won't be as pretty. And also, you see how my camera is in front of everything. To move it down, you go on the bottom right and you click on the arrow down. That way, the layer that we want, which is the lower third, is on top. Then right click, settings. And that's where you change everything. And you put it on this side. Okay, so this is where you can change your lower third. So for example, we do Wagos, and then we do creator. We do okay. We just move it a slightly bit. You can resize it. So you put it at the bottom left. And the thing that I want to show you as well is you can change colors if you don't like them with the hue. See? Ooh, looks good, eh? With the hue. And then we put it back to zero. Then we have, so you can lock it into position if you don't want it to move anymore. Enhance resize. Always do it. Doesn't do much. Hey, better than nothing. You can crop it if you want. Or you can do auto crop as well. Doesn't do much now because we haven't set any parameters except for the bottom. There you go. And then you can apply chroma key. This is all the options that you have for every source. You can, they have inbuilt filters. Let me show you with the camera. So with the settings, you get into filters, you get sharper the image, and you can move the slider around just to fine-tune where you want it to be or smoothen. You got cool. That change completely the colors, warm, and a few other ones. I like the old movie because it becomes black and white. Blue, this is a lot. But if you want to add some blue, you can do it like this. You can magnify. Oh my God, how big is my head? Or you can apply custom LUTs. You can find them easy online. Let's revert back to no filter. We got Skype feed. You have to connect Skype to Xplode, and that's how you do it. You can add an instant replay. What I mean, it's really good. I have to say it's really good. It's sort of like the replay button. So if you go into the settings, you can say system sound or stream only. I would recommend stream only. And then connect to, I want to say, Wugos Gaming, for example. And then hotkey. You can set up a hotkey. So, for example, Alt and Z in this case. And then replay time. We can put it 30 seconds. And then, okay. So, this is how you have the replay button. You can turn it off. And when you need it, you turn it on. And you record the last 30 seconds. Cool, eh? And then find more resources. This is the plugin store, and you want to click them all three so you can see both sources, extension and outputs. And the only one that I can recommend are Restream.io. If you don't know what Restream.io is, I'll be happy to do a video, but basically it's a website that lets you multi-stream to two platforms for free simultaneously. Then you have Twitch Alerts, Elgato Stream Deck if you own one, custom RNTP, for example, if you stream to Trovo, if you stream to Kick, this is the plugin that you want to install. YouTube Live Alerts, Audio Visualizer Beta, it's pretty good, and the beta is pretty solid, I want to say. OBS Scene Importer, so if you do have OBS, with this plugin, you can import all your scenes directly from OBS into Xsplite with push of one button, which is really, really good. Then you have Stream Chat Viewer, which allows you to see all your chats in one place, at least for YouTube, Twitch, and if you still use Facebook, I don't know what does, but if you do, let me know that in the comments. And then Spotify. So if you have a Spotify Premium and you do use the MCA free music playlist, this is how you show off on your stream what song you are playing. I know this is very, very easy, but stream, once you set up your stream, and here you can select where to go, and then record and screenshot. I know, but you'd be surprised how many people don't see it. So I thought I would share it. Before I leave you, this is the VCam. It already has my camera, but you can also connect your phone. If your phone is connected via Wi-Fi or via cable, you can connect it to your computer so you can use the webcam from your phone into Xsplite just with Xsplite Camera Connect on your phone and VCam. Let me show you. As you can see, my phone is connected and now it will change. There you go. As you can see, I am recording. Yes, I'm using OBS, but just for reference, this is what it looks like. All right, now we are back with my main camera. What I was talking about before is you can apply effects on your camera. For example, you can remove your background. It's not perfect, but I don't have a green screen behind me, so this is pretty good. The only thing that I want to add is it will be very intensive for your computer, so you may want to think twice if you want to use it. That's the same thing with changing the background, because on top of removing your background, it applies the background on top, so your PC has to be strong enough to do it. The background's look very, very good. One thing that you do want to change is when you go into settings, you want to make sure that, you know, everything is on, but also I'm giving you a bit of pause in between. So if you want to stop the video and copy my settings, you can. Screenshot, offline image, and then language. If you see the XSplit is not the most optimal settings based on your system hardware, that's where you calibrate it. It's going to take a few seconds, run a few tests. I have an RTX 3080, so it shouldn't be an issue. If you have a 20 series graphics card or 10 series graphics card, I don't know if I will recommend it, because it's very system intensive. And these are the camera settings. You can choose to remove or include the chair. Auto framing, there's a new feature. I don't know if it's going to be on the version that you have, but what auto framing does is see how my camera has got a line at the bottom. With the auto framing, it may crop it a bit, but it makes sure that you're all into frame, which is really, really good. You can enhance lighting. I don't particularly like it, but if you have a very dark room, you may use it. And then max resolution 1080p, you can see the setting applying to all qualities except for low power. Only recommended for more than high-end Intel or NVIDIA desktop hardware. The live stream, unless you do a first-person shooter, you want it to be at 30 FPS. Alrighty, guys. What do you think about XSplit? Do you think it will be better for you, XSplit or OBS? Before I end this video, I want to say a few words. The good points and the bad points. This video is not sponsored, nor XSplit is aware that I'm doing this video. I'm just doing this video because I like the software. So one of the pros is I don't want to pay monthly or yearly. No names here, but I don't want to pay monthly or yearly for a service. So the fact that they give the lifetime membership, it means that they're committed to keep going and they do listen to feedback. Also, you have a lot more things that you can do, like lower thirds. I don't know if anybody uses Skype these days, but just adding small functionality is something that you do want. Or the instant replay. Yes, you do have it on OBS as well. You have the A-Team plugin as well, but I think this is more seamless. I don't know. What do you think, guys? Other than that, it's pretty much similar to OBS. I also want to mention that XSplit VCam is a game changer, mostly because it doesn't force you to buy a webcam or a DSLR camera in order for you to stream with a face. I know there are other workarounds with OBS, but this is optimized for XSplit because it's the same company that makes it, right? So the fact that you can connect your phone to your PC wirelessly or with cable, if you decide to do so, and have your phone that you carry on with you every day as a webcam, this is amazing. For the bad, first point and foremost is it's heavier than OBS. You can see it. It has a lot of plugged steam to face is heavier. So if you have a low-end PC, this may not be for you. Second point, I don't know if you can notice, but my camera, when inserted into XSplit, had different colors than when the one into OBS. I don't know why it's happening, because I have no filters applied on OBS nor on XSplit, because we just added the camera. So to me, it's XSplit that has got weird colors. I don't know. Or maybe OBS is weird. I don't know. But to me, it appears a lot better on OBS than in XSplit, just for the colors. And third, $320 Australian, or I guess $250 American, is still pricey. With that said, there are some other companies that will take a lot more money in the long run No names here that will take a lot more money in the long run with having heavier software. So guys, what do you think? Would you use XSplits? I'm happy to keep doing XSplits content when they release new features and everything. Just let me know down below in the comment what you think, if you want even more help. So if you downloaded it and you still have questions, you still want to do something more, you don't know how to do it, let me know. And if you watched this far, I very, very, very much appreciate it. Because this is the reason why I do the videos, to help out. So if this video's helped out in any sort of way, don't forget to pop the like button, that way YouTube will share this video a lot more. And it helps me understand that I'm doing a good job. Hopefully I'm doing a good job. It's you guys that you tell me by watching the content that I do. If you watch the content, I know that my content can be good enough. Or it's good enough. I just spoke too much. I'll see you next week, guys. Happy creating.